Hi, my name is Lakhani Haresh and I'm the principal designer at HP Lakhani Associates. My firm came into being in the year 1994, which is more than two decades from now. And we have been practicing a lot of architecture and interior designing since then. We have handled projects for residential, commercial and office spaces, and also a lot of hospitals. This is a very interesting city house that we have designed in a very prime locality of Hyderabad called as Jubilee Hills, which is at a higher altitude. And the client is actually a very young couple, a very affluent business family. And as a part of a design brief, we were asked to design a house for 6 bedrooms, 3 to 4 servant rooms. They wanted a covered car parking for 5 to 6 cars. They wanted a huge lawn on the front of the house. And also they wanted a private pool. When we look at the site typically on Jubilee Hills, this is a rectangle piece of land which looks something like this. It's slightly askew towards the north side. What I'm trying to say is that the site is facing north. The north is the road. And on the rear end of the site, we have a width of 65 feet. On the front side, we have 81 feet. And the total depth of the site is about 160 feet. Now, if you look at this as a north, the north is actually stretched out by 15 degrees towards the west. The context of Jubilee Hills is extraordinary. Actually, we didn't have to struggle too hard to position or to design the house on this space because everything that I look into the surrounding was beautiful. The only drawback that it was, when I was standing on this piece of land, I could practically not see the total piece of extent of the land. This is the road on the northern side, and if I look at it, it was practically drooping down by 15 to 16 meters. So what we decided was, we tried to position the house somewhere towards the southwestern side of the property, leaving the minimum setbacks onto the western side, a little more than the minimum on the southern side. As a result, we got nearly 20 feet on the front and we got about 50 feet on the northern side. As a result, we positioned the gate right on the northeastern quadrant of the property and we were able to manage a ramp which would go off to a drop-off point on the northeastern corner of the house. Well, let me just put it this way. First, coming back to the specifications which were given by the client, we were worried on a topography like this, how am I going to be giving spaces to him to accommodate car parkings, covered car parkings for at least 6 to 7 cars, give utility spaces, 3 or 4 servant rooms. And we have such a huge void over here. And the cost of filling this void was humongous. So instead of trying to fill up this entire space, what we decided to have a basement. If you look at this plan, this is the flow of the plan. I'm entering from the northeastern side. Onto this side, on the northeast, that is the east part of the house, I have a drop-off point of the car from where it goes directly into the cellar, where I have a provision of a lot of car parks, which are marked in this blue color. Also, you can notice that there are no columns in the middle. This was one of the unique features of the house. We designed the structure in such a way that the columns were placed onto the periphery with a huge PT beams on the top. And the entire structure on the southwest is actually floating on these beams. So from the basement, we also have one more door which could lead us to the lift and, you know, we can go on to any level of the house. When I look at the ground floor, the way it is arranged, this is how the drop-off point looks, where I just have 5 steps to go into the house and I'm entering into the central core of the house where a staircase and lift is also positioned. Now, this is a space which we call as a Brahmasthanam as per Vastu. And this space has been so designed that the house has been literally zoned into 2 parts. One is the formal part, which is on the right hand side, and the other is the informal, which is on the left. If you look at the section of this particular space, it is a double heighted area, which is open to sky. Open to sky in a way that I have a skylight, of course, for the protection of rain, but you have a direct infusion of sunlight coming in from these areas during the morning times. But during, again, in the evening times and afternoons, we have a staircase core through which the light comes in after 4:30 in the evening. So during the entire time of the day, I think we have a fantastic ventilation in the house. So coming back to the floor plan, on the right hand side, what we have is a formal area, which is a huge drawing room, and it opens out in the sprawling landscape on the front side. On the eastern side, like I said, on the eastern side, we were a little concerned because there is a structure which is practically unoccupied and it was one of the most awkward things of this site.
So what we did is, to screen this structure off, we created a vertical green element, a green wall right in front of the main door, which not only screened the house from this, but it also gave a fantastic aura and appearance. As soon as you go into the house or you're coming out of the house, this is what you're welcomed with. Along with that, there were additional landscaping features, water bodies, which were placed onto this site. And because of the way the house is positioned, we were able to get a fantastic amount of green spaces toward the northeastern part of the house, also towards the west. And we were also able to give a huge deck for the parents whose bedrooms were positioned in the ground floor.
So as soon as you come out of this central core, which is a staircase area or a lift, onto the right-hand side, we have a guest bedroom. We have one of the kids' room, which is basically a son's room. And these two rooms are connected with a huge balcony, which is an integral part of the elevation feature of the house. And when you are walking onto the right side, which is a more private zone, you have a daughter's bedroom, a walk-in closet, and a toilet. And we have a massive master bedroom with a master den and a sleeping area. Second floor is a semi-constructed space, but what we have done over here, we have a double layered slab on towards the southwestern side because we have positioned a swimming pool and entertainment areas on this floor. So if you see, as you walk into this area, you are going up by literally 3.5 feet, creating an underdeck for the pool and giving a depth to the pool. We have a huge lap pool over here, which is about 12 feet wide and it's about 36 feet in length, having a depth of 3 to 6 feet from left to right, with a nice sitting deck spaces onto one side. And when you are onto this side, that is the northern side, you have a nice shaded garden, a huge deck to sit out, and you have a beautiful space for working out.
Well, like I said earlier, that this was a house for a small family of husband, wife, two children. They also had their parents who were going to be occupying this house occasionally. But the very interesting part was that this family had always lived as a joint family, as a communion, with two sons growing up in the same house. And it was father's aspiration to build two houses for two sons in the prime locations. So this was the first one of it. And interestingly, there was a participation from everyone, which was overwhelming experience for our entire firm. So we at some point didn't understand whether we are designing the house for this couple, it's for the parents, or it was for his brother. It was such a warm feeling. I think we really enjoyed and cherished that experience.